MIT used its tax-exempt power as an educational institution, which gave it a huge competitive advantage over private sector people to acquire real estate in the dying businesses, the manufacturing that was moving out, the warehousing that was moving out, the simplex wire. So MIT used that competitive advantage, allegedly for educational purposes, and I think in some cases probably sincerely for educational purposes, at that time, to pick up the real estate to reach Kendall Square and begin giving the cachet that there was technology here. The biggest driver of gentrification in Cambridge is MIT. MIT had a strategy for decades of housing 50% of their graduate students on campus. In my view, it was not adequate, but it was a strategy. There were two, Bob Simha told me yesterday, who's a former planning director at MIT, there were 2,000 dwelling units, 2,000 beds of housing on the books ready to go when he left. MIT dropped that policy. And just the difference to 50% from, they claim 39%, but they're leaving out the postdocs. They're down around 30%. Subtract 30 from 100, figure out the math. There are, if MIT were housing 100% of its postdocs and graduate students, which I think in this economy is the appropriate level, that's 5,000 beds. The lack of that housing, those students, very nice people, they are the blockbusters, they are the agents of gentrification, because they will live in more density and they will pay rents that no family can afford. That's what's the shock troops of gentrification is, and I'm not blaming the students, it's MIT as an institute which has disgracefully failed to step up to the plate of providing housing that its own function relies on. MIT cannot function without those research associates. It's disgraceful. I work for MIT. They can throw me out if they want to, and oh man, I don't give a damn. What they're doing is reprehensible. The jobs at Kendall without housing, I like to see the jobs growing, but if you don't add especially transit, you've got a problem. How are you going to get the people there? You're now forcing people to walk. That's nice for their health, but it means if they have to walk, they're going to push someone else out of that housing. So the lack of transit and the lack of housing is a double whammy that's very bad.